Okay, this is Tom. Several people have asked me why I haven't put my favorite five up yet, and I guess it's maybe just because I'm a little bit lazy and didn't want to dig everything out, but I had some time this afternoon, Sunday afternoon, and I thought that I would put something up here. So actually, Jenny's going to help me.
Hello.
Okay, well, I'm going to start with this piece here, and some of you may have seen this already, but this is a pendant, I'm guessing maybe a gorget. And as you can see, I have two pieces of this gorget. And the reason this is one of my favorite five is because I found these two pieces in 2 years back to back on the same field, which doesn't always happen. But thought that was kind of neat. And I was happy with that, and I came home, glued them together. So that's my first favorite find. Now, Jenny, you have a favorite find there.
Well, this is another part of that gorget.
I was going to say, that doesn't look real special.
No, it's just a little piece, but I found it before we were married, so it meant we had to be married.
So I invited you to go hunt arrowheads with me.
Right.
And you found this piece.
Yep, in the same field.
And we couldn't believe it, but when we got home, look at that. Look at that. Third piece of it.
Mm-hmm.
Whole.
About 27 years ago.
Yeah. That's a long time.
Mm-hmm.
Are we that old?
No. We were a child.
Okay. Right. We were hunting when we were 10. So that's probably my favorite find because it's a piece that Jenny and I both found together and contributed to. There is a piece missing. So hopefully someday we'll be able to complete that piece. All right, so I also want to show you this piece. Some of you may have seen this before as well. This is my dovetail that I found. Probably I was about 21 years old when I found this one. Some of you have heard me talk about my friend Ed. I was actually hunting with Ed when I found this, and man, you should have heard him giving it to me, giving me the business when I found this. And it's probably the nicest piece I have in my collection. But I also know that I think deep down Ed was pretty happy for me finding that piece. But that's about as good as they come. Alright, and then this is another piece that's a favorite of mine. I found this, again, probably around the same time. This is a Hopewell piece. I know a lot of you will call this a Snyder's Point. It's a middle woodland point and associated with the Hopewell culture up here in Ohio. It is very characteristic that a lot of these are made of Flint Ridge, colorful Flint Ridge, and you can see the swirly colors through that. Again, one of the nicer pieces in my collection. All right. Jenny, you want to talk about this piece?
I found it.
Yes, you did.
First year we were married.
How much of that was showing?
It was just which part was it? Very little.
Yeah.
About, I don't know.
I remember that.
Meter.
So there was barely anything of this showing, and Jenny called me over and said, hey, I think I found something. This was when, you know, we used to look at it before we'd yank it out of the ground, but it was before we had cameras, and it ended up being a 4-inch blade, and it's really an interesting piece. I don't know if you can see the beveling along this entire edge. On this side too, sharp as can be. There's no grinding on it. You
That's
always have done better than me when I take you along.
You should take me more often.
Well, I try. All right, so that's again another favorite. Obviously, we were hunting together that day, so maybe that's why it's one of my favorites. All right, and then I don't know for those of you, again, that have been watching me for a long time, this was, I think, the first video that I ever posted, and this is that my only crick find ever. Found it in a crick bank at my brother-in-law's. We were talking about the recent flooding that he had had at his place, and he had kind of just a drainage crick. I don't know, when I go to put this video up, if I have a clip of that, maybe I'll stick that in right here. So if I break away and show you that, it's a flashback of me finding this point. Probably some sort of a early woodland. It's a stem point. It has a little bit of a Hopewell look to it. Again, right material. Yeah, it got a little bit of a chip off the base there, but other than that, it's a pretty good piece. I think it's one of my favorites because of the way that we found it, and it's my only ever crick find. And I know we're supposed to stop at 5, but I want to show you this this thing too. You might say, oh, that's a pretty cool looking pestle. Let me get it over here where you can see a little bit better. Pretty neat looking pestle it is, but what's really cool about this one is you can see, that's not showing up well. And I'm trying to get some good light here. There we go. You can see that this, the bottom of this, is completely worn off. Let me get out of here where you can see it better. There we go. So not only was it a pestle, but it was, you can see how the grinding motion that wore that bottom off. It was probably one of the first stone pieces that I ever picked up. You know, when I first started hunting arrowheads, I didn't really know to look for the stone pieces, but I knew that that didn't occur naturally. Okay, well, there's Commissioner Tom, and this is Commissioner Tom's. Oh,
hold on. Tell me when you're going to put that camera on.
Favorite 5. All right, this is Commissioner Tom signing off.